Good morning all of you. Welcome to Nirja Education. Today we are going to discuss the chapter Matter in Our Surroundings. The first part already I explained. If you haven't gone through that part, please go through that part and subscribe our channel Nirja Education. Now we will go to this video. In this video we are going to discuss on the different states of matter. Already I told you in my previous video that here we are dividing the particles according to the physical property of the particles or physical property of the matter. According to the physical property, matter can be divided into 5 states, that is solid, liquid, gas, plasma and Bose-Einstein condensate. I will explain once again, matter can be divided into 5 states: solid, liquid, gas, plasma and Bose-Einstein condensate. These two you will learn in higher classes. In this chapter we are going to deal with these 3 states of matter, that is solid, liquid and gas. First we will go to our first one, that is solids. So here you can see this one. Already I told you that the matter is made up of particles. This is the arrangement of particles in the matter. You can see how these particles are arranged in this matter. You saw this one is, they are closely packed in this one. The particles are closely packed in this one. That is the first point. The particles are closely packed in the solids. Second thing, they are having definite shape and volume. You know that one. Any solid thing that you can see around you, you just watch that one. They are having definite shape and volume. When you take the chalk, this is having definite shape and volume. When you take duster or anything, bottle, box, anything, all these are example for solids. They are having definite shape and volume. Why they are having definite shape and volume? Because the particles are closely packed, so they can't move here and there. They are bound together. They are closely bound together. So the intermolecular force of attraction will be more. The intermolecular force of attraction will be more in case of solids. And they are having definite shape and volume. The next one is high density. What do you mean by density? What is the equation for density? The equation for density is mass by volume. That means if you are taking one unit volume of things, in that so many particles will be there, because in solids the particles are closely packed. So if you take a unit area, you can find so many particles in that place, so that the density of solids will be high. All these are due to the arrangement of particles in the solids. The next one is diffusion. Already in the previous video we discussed what is diffusion. What is diffusion? The intermixing of particles of matter by their own. Here you can see that the space between the particles are very less. The intermolecular space, because they are closely packed, the force of attraction is very more, so that the space between these particles are very less. So they can't diffuse. The space is very less, so the particles can't diffuse. The diffusion rate is very low in the case of solids. These are the some of the properties of the solids. I will explain once again. The particles are closely packed. This is the particle arrangement of solids. The particles are closely packed. The force of attraction between these particles will be more, and they are having high density, they are having definite shape and volume and no diffusion, and the force of attraction between the particle is more. And one more thing, they are not compressible. If you are trying to compress the solid things, it will be very difficult. They will break down. If you apply force on that one, they will break down. So it is very difficult to compress the solid substances. Then you will ask, madam, what about sponge? Sponge we are considering as solid only, but we can compress that one. Is it right or wrong? Yes, we can compress. Why? Because in sponge you can see so much small holes in that one. Pores will be there. In that pores, the air holes. Actually, that is air holes. The air is occupying in that pores or holes. So what will happen when you compress this? So this gas can escape from this holes. So when all the gas will escape from this holes, what will happen? Then you can't compress this one. Then you can't compress the sponge. That is why you can compress, because the gas particles are there inside this sponge. That is why you can compress the sponge. Otherwise, we are considering it. Otherwise, you can't compress it. So, sponge is also a solid substance. Next, we are going to the next stage of matter, that is liquid. You can see the particle arrangement in liquid. You can see the space between the particles. In here, the particles are not closely packed like in the solids. There will be space between the particles of the liquid. So, what will happen? The force of attraction between the particle will also less. Here, the force of attraction between the particle is also less, because they are arranged. They are arranged in such a manner that there will be a space between the particles. The next one is, they don't have definite shape. You know that one, liquids, they don't have definite shape. When you take any liquid, milk, water or anything, if you are pouring in any container, suppose if you are taking in a bottle, it will acquire the shape of the bottle. If you are pouring it into any can or any beaker or something, it will take the shape of that container. That means liquids, they don't have definite shape, but they acquire the shape of the container in which they are taking. And the third, next point is that they are having definite volume. Liquids, already we told that they don't have definite shape, but they are having definite volume, because if you take a unit space, the particles will be there. So that is why they are having definite volume. And density. Density will be less, because the particles are arranged far there in a such a manner that space will be there. So when we are comparing liquids and solids, the density of these liquids will be very less. The particles that you can see in a square meter or in a particular volume you are taking, the particles will be very less compared to solids. So that density of these liquids will be very less when we are comparing to the solids. Next, one of the property of the liquid is that they can flow. The liquids can flow. So they are known as fluids. The liquids and gases together known as fluids, because they can flow. Why these liquids can flow? Because already we discussed that the force of attraction between the particles will be very less. So these layers can slide over one another. These layers can slide over one another, because of less force of attraction. That is the reason why these liquids can flow, but they can't escape out like gases. Gases, you know that when it is no open container, the gases will escape out, but the water can't escape out from the container. So some of the force of attraction will be there, but they can flow. Why they can flow? Because the force of attraction is less, so the layer can slide one over the other. That is the reason why these liquids can flow. I hope all of you have understood the properties of the liquids. Now we will go to the next states of matter, that are gases. The particle arrangement of gases, you can see they are very free to move, because the particles are arranged far apart from one another. So the space between these particles are very large, and the particles are free to move, and they don't have definite shape. You know that the gases, they don't have definite shape. Why? Because they are arranged far apart from each other. So the attractive force between the particles will also negligible. They don't have that much force of attraction. So we can tell that the force of attraction between the particles are very negligible. That already I have written here. The intermolecular force is negligible. So this also can flow. This also known as fluid. Gases are also known as fluids because the force of attraction between them is negligible. So they are very free to move anywhere. They like to move anywhere. That is the one of the property of these gases. So these are the properties of the gases. Particles are free to move, no definite shape, intermolecular force is negligible, and they are highly compressible. I hope all of you have understood about the different states of matter, that is solids, liquids and gases. The effect of temperature, pressure on these three states of matter, I will explain in my next video. Thank you.